Okay, good morning, everybody. Nice to see you all. Yes, welcome, everybody, to our all-age service. My name is Mike. I want us to start slightly differently this morning. I want us to start with a question. It's a question everybody can answer, whatever your age is, provided you can talk. Okay? And what I want you to do is to shout out the answer to my question three times, as loudly as you can. So I should go one, two, three, and then you shout out the answer. Then after that, you stand up and be as quiet as you can, because we're going to have a prayer. Okay, got that? So you don't know what the question is yet, do you? I'll tell you what the question is, and then I count one, two, three, and you shout the answer three times loudly. And the question is this: what is your name? One, two, three. Mike. Father God, we've told you what our names are, and we thank you that we know that your name is Father, that your name is Jesus, that your name is Lord, and we're here to meet you, and we thank you that you promise that you will meet us. So Lord God, we're in church, and we thank you that you're here with us today. And we ask that you'll help us as we share in this service together. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Sing the song, Jesus is Lord. Please sit down. Now, who saw fireworks last night? Put your hands up if you did. Okay, who had fireworks in their garden or in a friend's garden? Okay, who went to a firework display? Okay, who can tell me what your favourite firework is? What sort of firework you like? Yes?
A big red one.
You like a big red one. Okay, brilliant. William? You like big yellow sparkly one. Right. Anybody else got a favourite firework? Yes. Oh, what? A Catherine wheel, yes. Now then, today, because we go to big displays, sometimes we don't see some of the older fashioned fireworks. I'll talk about those in a minute, but a Catherine wheel, it goes round and round and round. Very exciting. Who else has got a favourite firework?
A blue one.
A blue one. Okay, fine. And yeah.
A rocket.
A rocket, right. A rocket that goes right up there, yeah. Do you know, in the old days, and I'm old, they used to make fireworks that you can't buy anymore. Does anybody remember a firework called a jumping jack? Hey, yes. And the thing is, you lit it, and then it jumped, and it jumped, and it moved around. And if you weren't careful, it hit you on the bottom of your trousers, and it was dangerous. That's why they don't make jumping jacks anymore, because we have to have health and safety. Who remembers planes, fireworks that took off? Oh, I used to have those. And helicopters, fireworks that, well, like a helicopter. They used to be really exciting fireworks, but they weren't safe, so we don't have them anymore. But lots of fireworks, when they go up in the air, especially Arthur's rockets, they produce stars. You get a whole lot of different stars, sparkly stars, and that's wonderful. And that's made me think about today, and we're going to talk about stars today. So I've called what we're doing today Star Talk. So we're going to think about stars. Now then, if you want to do some drawing during today's service, we've got some paper here, got loads of pens, and if you get fed up and a bit bored with what's going on, come and get a piece of paper, and I want you to do a drawing of sun, moon, or stars. Or sun, moon, and stars. Or sun and moon and sun and stars. Okay, so as soon as you want to come and do a bit of drawing and do something different, come get yourself a piece of paper, take some pens, and do a drawing, and we'll show those drawings at the end if anybody's done them. Okay. Now then, who likes maths? Put your hands up if you like maths. Right, because we're going to do some maths now. And on the screen are going to be some numbers. Oh, there's our fireworks. Thank you. And now we've got some numbers. Lots of funny numbers there. The first number, 200 billion trillion, or all the noughts written out, are the number of stars that scientists think are in the universe. And they say that it's more than the number of grains of sand on all the beaches in all the world. So if you think about the world, you think about all the sandy beaches, think about all those tiny bits of sand, there's more stars in the sky than there are grains of sand on all the beaches in the world. 200 billion trillion, as far as we know, and we're always discovering more. Now, somewhere between 3,000 and 6,000 of those stars can actually be seen from Earth with telescopes. So it depends where you are, it depends how dark the sky is, it depends how good your telescope is, but people can see between 3,000 and 6,000 stars. 200 billion of those stars are in our galaxy. And 2 trillion are the number of galaxies that people have found so far. And the last number there, 3 billion light years, is try to answer the question, how big is our universe? And we don't actually measure it in miles, so it's slightly different, but a light year is about 6 trillion miles. And at the moment, they think the universe is about 3 billion light years, but it's getting bigger all the time. So the universe will be bigger at the end of the service than it was at the beginning, which is quite incredible. So there are some amazing facts about our universe. Now then, on screen now are 2 verses in the Bible. I'd like you to help me by reading them together because they talk about this amazing universe and our God. First of all, from Psalm 19, verse 1. Can you read it with me? How clearly the sky reveals God's glory. How plainly it shows what he has done. Look at the sky and you see how glorious God is. And the other verse there from Isaiah, look up at the sky. Who created all you can see? The Lord makes the stars come out at night, one by one. His power and strength are great. So the Bible tells us that the stars remind us how brilliant and great and fantastic our God is. Now we're going to listen to a song. Sometimes we sing this song, but we're going to listen to it. It's a song called Indescribable. If we can have the lights out, that will make the visuals a little bit better to see, I think. It's a song by Chris Tomlin. Let's just pray together for a moment. Lord God, that song says you're amazing. And when we think about the amazing world that we live in, the incredible universe, we know how great and wonderful and marvelous you are. Lord, you are amazing, and we thank you. We thank you that you've made this incredible world that we live in. And we thank you for your power, for your brilliance, for your majesty. Thank you, Lord God, that you've worked it all out. Thank you that you're the great creator. Thank you for all your goodness and all your love. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, I don't know, we can have the lights back on now, I think. I don't know how many of you are good at writing poems, but I'm going to give a challenge. If anybody can write a poem about stars or space or sun or moon, anything like that, I will give a prize to the best poem. You don't have to do it today, of course. You have to think about it during the week and either email it to Kevin, who can send it to me, or email it to me if you can access my details on the church website or church suite. So think about that. See if you can write a poem. I've got a poem here that my friend wrote a long time ago. He wrote it to a tune, but we're not going to be able to sing it to that tune because I think there's copyright things about it. So we're going to do my friend's poem in a moment, but I need you to help me do the chorus. And the chorus has got an O, O, O in it. And it goes like this. O, 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 O. Can you do that? One, two, three. O, 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 O. Right. One more time. O, 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 O. Right. Okay. So when you get to the chorus, I want you to read the words of the chorus and to do the O, O, O's. I'm going to read the first verse. Well, it's only one verse. It's a one-verse poem. And this is how the verse goes. I look at the stars at this awesome display and think they are thousands of light years away. Yet God made each one and he put them in place. He's greater than even the vastness of space. Now, your turn. Oh, see the stars tonight. Oh, praise God for his might. Oh, 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 oh. It is plain to see. Oh, 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 oh. His power and majesty. Now, that's my friend Phil's poem. But I'm sure you can write one as good, if not better. So there's the challenge. See if you can write a space poem. Now, throughout this morning, I've got a few quiz questions. And there's a little prize for the person who gets it right. Because I'm not very good at seeing who puts their hand up first, Caroline's going to be my spotter. So make sure Caroline can see your hand. As soon as you know the answer to this question, you can put your hand up. What is the name of the fourth planet from the sun, the second smallest, known as the red planet, named after the god of war? Do we have a hand up? Mars. Okay. Come and get your prize then. Now, there is one caveat. Before I give you your Mars bar, you're not allowed to eat it during the service. You have to wait to the end. And the other thing is, having had one prize, next time we get to a question, afraid I can't accept your answer. Okay, so there will be some more chances to win prizes a bit later on. We're going to sing another song. You're the Word of God the Father. very much. Do sit down again. Now, I've got a picture to show you. This is a question without a prize, all right? That means you can take part, of course. And the question is, who is it in the picture? And I hope that those of you who are watching on screen are able to see this as well. Can anybody tell me the name of this man?
Tim Peak.
Tim Peak. Thank you very much. What can you tell me about Tim Peak? British astronaut, yes. Do you know Tim Peak was in Warwick a few weeks ago? He was speaking at the Art Centre talking about his time in space. And I was very privileged to be there with my son-in-law. And we had a great evening listening to Tim Peak tell you all sorts of stories, answering questions like, how do you eat in space? How do you go to the toilet in space? All sorts of things that people want to know. In fact, more people want to know about the toilet than the eating, but there you are. So he told us all that in lovely detail that I'm not going to pass on to you today. But he's touring the country telling these stories. Now, one of the things Tim Peake said was, when you're up at the space station and you look down at the Earth, it's amazing how small the things that we think are important really are. Because you look at the Earth and you can't see the barriers between nations and countries. You can just see the land masses. We divide our world into little bits, and this belongs to this country, this belongs to that, and we have borders, and even in the middle of an island we have a border, and this is north and this is south. You can't see any of that from space. And you can't even see people from space. We're so tiny, you can't see us. And somebody in the Bible, writing one of the Psalms, had that idea and talked about it. And Gabby's going to come and read to us now. And I'd like you to listen very carefully to the words that Gabby reads to us. So thank you, Gabby. You'd like to stand there, and I'll put the microphone there, and we can all hear you.
The reading is from Psalm 8, verses 1 to 4. Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory in the heavens. Through the praise of children and infants, you have established a fortress against your enemies to silence those who are against you. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place, what are the people of the earth that you are concerned about them, or human beings that you care for them?
Thank you, Gabby. Yeah. The psalm writer says, what are people of the earth? We're so small, fancy God, who made everything, actually caring about me. And there are two amazing things that I want you to take away from today. The amazing thing that God made all this stuff, this huge world, this great universe. And the amazing thing that, tiny as I am, God loves me. And God cares about me. And God loves you, and God cares about you. And all these great things that God has made doesn't alter the fact that he still cares about little me and little you. Let's have a prayer together. Dear God, sometimes we think we're bigger than we really are. Sometimes we think we're more important than we really are. Sometimes we think that we're the one that really matters, and we forget that really we're very small. But we thank you that even though we're small, even though we're tiny, even though we're invisible from the International Space Station, thank you, Lord, that you still see us and you know about us and you care about us. That you're not just the God of big things, but you're the God of small things as well. And you're the God of ordinary people like us, of adults and children and babies. Thank you, Lord God, that you care. So we're sorry for the times when we've thought ourselves to be more important and better when we're not really. And we thank you that despite how small we are and despite all the mistakes we make, you forgive us and you love us and you help us and you make us strong. Thank you, Lord God, for that amazing thing. Amen. Amen. Oh, I think it's time for a second question. Right. Caroline's got her spotting eyes on once more. What do you call, are you ready, a huge collection of dust, gas, billions of stars and solar systems all held together by gravity? That wasn't the answer that I had. There's another. Sorry? Yeah? Galaxy is my answer, yeah. Now, you can't buy chocolate called Nebula, so you have to have a galaxy, you see. Now, we're going to sing a song, especially for younger people and people who like doing actions. I'm going to teach you the actions. So can I have some people up here who I'm going to teach the actions to? Now, I want to tell you something about actions, and that is I'm really bad at them. And if you want to laugh, when we're doing an action song, look at me and I'll get it wrong. I'll be doing that when I should be doing that. And I'm really bad at doing the submarine and doing that bit in that song. So this is a really simple action. We're asking a question. And in the first verse, the question is, who made the twinkling stars? And we ask the question by doing a question mark. Who? Question mark. And then the dot at the end is the made. And then we do twinkling stars. That's all you have to do. Who made the twinkling stars? The second verse talks about seas. Yeah, we want more volunteers up here. That's brilliant. And that is, who made the seas that flow? You can do seas. Excellent. The third verse is, who made the birds that fly? And the fourth verse is, who made both you and me? You and me, you and me. And the last verse is, who made the twinkling stars, the seas that flow, the birds that fly, you and me? Ah, okay. Now, our musicians have learnt this song, and they're going to help us to sing it. Who made the twinkling stars? And I've now got my team doing the actions. Team here, well done. Thank you very much. That's brilliant. And I don't know how many of you are watching me, but I got mixed up between birds that fly and seas that flow. So I had seas that flied and birds that flowed. But there we are. I told you I was no good with actions. But you were brilliant. Thank you very much. Oh, I think it's time for a question. What is the name of... This is an easy one, so it's... Hands will go up really quickly. What is the name of the galaxy that includes our solar system? The Milky Way. Excellent. Come up and collect your Milky Way magic stars. Now, before I moved to live in this area some year and three quarters ago, we used to live in Cambridge. And one of the things about Cambridge, it has a big university. And one of the things about the university, it has a big department that studies astronomy, it studies the stars. And one of the amazing things about the astronomy department at Cambridge University is that once a month, on a Wednesday night, they let members of the public, ordinary people like you and me, look through their telescopes. They do a talk. And lots of children come to it. It's usually absolutely packed out. And then you can look through the telescopes. And it's amazing to see these huge, big telescopes. And you can see the night sky. The best thing I ever saw was the planet Jupiter and four of its moons really clearly through their telescope. So if any of you live in Cambridge, find out when the astronomy department is letting the members of the public use their telescopes. And there's always people there to show you what to do and show you what you're seeing, and it's really good fun. Now then, I want to show us a picture of a planet. And this is a real picture, and it's something that you are able to see. You don't have to go abroad to see it. Does anybody know the name of that planet that you're looking at? The moon's a bit at the top. Yeah, I should tell you that. At the top left, there is the moon. But at the bottom middle, there's something else. Sorry? It is Venus. You're absolutely right. It's the planet Venus. And you know, Venus is called the morning star. And I'll tell you why it's called the morning star. It's because, and there's a picture of the planet Venus a bit more close up. It's called the morning star because Venus is visible in the night sky just before the sun comes up. So when you can see the planet Venus, you know that it's not long before morning's coming. And so that's why they called it the morning star. And sailors used, before they had all the electronic equipment we have now, they used to use the planets to show them where they were, and they used the planet Venus, particularly the morning star, to help guide them. It was called the star that brings joy because it made people happy that the day was coming and the night was going away. That's the planet Venus, a morning star. Do you know, on the planet Venus, a day is about the same as a year in this planet where we are. So a year of our time is one day on the planet Venus. And the planet Venus is actually hotter than Mars. So not somewhere you want to go very quickly. But one other thing about the planet Venus, did you know that planets always spin around? And they always spin anti-clockwise. That's the opposite direction clock goes, apart from Venus. And it's different. And it goes the other way around to all the other planets. The morning star. And Jesus has been called in the Bible the morning star. Jesus. Because he brings joy. Because he brings the end of darkness and the beginning of day. Because he is different to anybody else. And so we're going to think about Jesus, the bright morning star. We've got a couple of songs that we're going to sing. We're going to sing one of them, Almighty God, and then we're going to go into another and come back to the first song. So let's have our song, Almighty God, We Bring You Praise. Thank you. Thank you. Please sit down. Now, you should all have one of these pictures. If you've got it, can you hold it up? If you haven't, we need to get some more. Has anybody not got one of our pictures? I think there's some people here who haven't got one. One at the front here. Right, has everybody got one? Right. Now, I'll tell you what these are about. I want you to put your hands up, and you, whatever age you are, you can do it on screen as well. Can you put your hands up if your mum or dad ever said to you, "You're not very observant"? Put your hands up. Because what does it mean, not being observant? Can anybody tell me that? Sorry? You don't notice things. When your wife's had her hair done and you haven't even noticed it's different, Alan. Yes. Or when your mum's put a lovely bunch of flowers up in the house and you don't notice it. Or when your brother or sister's had something new to wear and they're really proud of it and you haven't even seen it. Are any of you ever like that, when you don't notice things, you don't see things? Put your hand up if you're ever a little bit like that. Or I think lots of us are. Well, that's what this person is here. This is somebody who's shut their eyes, put their hands over their eyes so they can't see and they don't take any notice. Now, do you know that there are a lot of people who do that with Jesus? They don't open their eyes. They don't look at Jesus. They don't see who he is. They're not very observant. They just shut their eyes and say, "I can't be bothered. I'm not interested. I don't want to know." So here's a question for you. What is best, to have your eyes open and to be able to see, or to have your eyes shut and not look and not be bothered? If you think that this is a bad thing, I'm going to give you something to do in a minute. If you think it's a good thing, I want you to take it home. Take it and don't know what you're going to do with it at home, but nobody will notice it anyway, so it's fine. If you think it's a bad thing, I want you to do this. I want you to screw it up. And I need two volunteers. Molly, can you help me?
Yeah.
Right. I want you to go around with a waste paper basket and collect some of the screwed up papers. And somebody else who can do it. Yeah, can you come and help me too? Right, you go. That's you. Right, you organise yourselves. That's fine. So if you've got a screwed up paper, you can put it in there. If you think it's a good thing, take it home with you. And if you're watching online, I'm sorry you can't put them in our bins, but you can put them in your bin somewhere. And the ones in the bin eventually will be recycled, I need to tell you that. We're still collecting at the back there. Brilliant, thank you very much. My rubbish collectors. I'll put them all together like that. And I'm going to take them to the cross and give them to Jesus. And we're going to pray a prayer. Oh, another one to go in with it. Thank you. We're going to pray a prayer. Lord God, it's a bit rubbish when we shut our eyes and when we don't look at Jesus. We don't think about you and we don't notice who you are. Please forgive us when our eyes are shut and help our eyes to be open so that we can see you and see who you are and see the way in which you're like a bright light shining in our world. Help us, Lord, to be observant. Amen. I think it's time for another question. This is a question that we're going to aim at the under 20s or so, okay? Very easy question, this. The sun is not a planet. What is it? Molly, what is it?
A star.
It's a star. And in my pocket, there is a star bar, especially for you, because you're a star. I think it's time we sang again, don't you? We're going to sing about Jesus being a star. Shine, Jesus, shine. Things I enjoy doing on a Tuesday is having time with my grandson. My grandson, Caspi, is 3 years old. And one of his favourite games is playing with my torch. Let's just run out of battery. Okay. Oh, that's naughty of it. Anyway, he loves playing with my torch. It wouldn't have shown up very well here, but at least you can see the torch. And fortunately, it's rechargeable, so that's we can sort it out when we get home. But he loves going into a darkened room, and you can make the beam bigger or smaller by moving that. And he loves doing that. You make it flash. He loves playing with my torch. I've worn it out. Yes, probably have. He's worn it out, yes. And when I was a child, I loved playing with my torch. I had a torch that had five different colours on it. Ooh, it was a really posh torch. And there was nothing better than lying in bed in the dark and getting your torch out and making coloured patterns on the wall and on the ceiling and all sorts of things. But I can't get coloured torches like that now. However, this torch is fun for my son Caspian. Now, there's a verse in the Bible that I want you to look at. And it's the last verse we're going to look at. And we're going to say it all together when it comes up on the screen. And it's a verse that I'm reminded of by my torch. Let's say it together. You must shine among them like stars, lighting up the sky. That was St. Paul writing to Christians and saying, we're to be like stars, lighting up the sky. In other words, we're to be like a light torch in the midst of darkness. And what Paul was saying was we live in a world that is sometimes a bit dark and a bit sad, and bad things go on, and people are hurting, and it's painful. And we're to there to bring light in the darkness. We're to be shining, showing good things and love and care. We're to be like stars shining in a dark world. And that's the challenge for you and me as we think about stars. Not only did God create all the stars, he wants me to be like a star shining in a dark world. Some of the things that we do to be stars are actually here at the front of the church, because these shoeboxes are like stars shining in the darkness. People who have very little, don't have toys at Christmas like we do, people who are very, very underprivileged will receive these gifts, and that will bring joy to them. That will be a ray of light, and giving these gifts is like being a star in a dark sky. So we're going to pray for these gifts and pray that God will help us to be stars. Lord God, we thank you for these gifts, these shoeboxes that are going to go to Romania. And we pray for the people who receive them, that those gifts might bring them joy and happiness at Christmas, that it might be light in their darkness, that it might be joy in their hard lives, that it might bring a smile to their faces. And we ask, Lord God, that it would bless them in all kinds of ways. Help us, Lord God, to be stars, to shine light in your darkness. And wherever people, Lord, are trying to bring light into darkness, be with them. We pray this day for the people meeting in Egypt, trying to stop the climate change that's making our planet a worse place to live. And we pray for all those who are gathered there, that you'll help them to make good decisions that they can follow through, that will bring light into darkness. So, Lord God, let your light shine in the darkness and help us to be stars shining like Jesus did. Amen. I'm going to sing a song, "From Heaven You Came, Helpless Babe." Ah, but before we do that, yes, I've got another question. I think this better be for those who are under 20 as well. Last question. This is, I want a word. The word begins with C. I probably used it today. It's a word that means this world didn't just happen. It wasn't an accident, but God actually thought it and worked it out. And Molly's had a present, so she... What's over there, which one? Okay, what is the answer to my question? Sorry. Creation. Yes. Fortunately, Cadbury's do something called marvellous creations. And God has made a marvellous creation. So have the marvellous creation. Now, has anybody done a drawing? Are there any drawings? If so, come and bring them up. We'll have a look at them. We got one here. Okay. This is not mine, but this is Florrie's. Anybody else got one? Thank you. Yeah, come up here, will you, so we can all see it. That's it. Come and hold them up so we can all see them. Oh, we've got more coming. Wow, we've got lots of drawings here. And Mummy helped as well, so well done to Mummy. Okay, I think a clap for everybody who's done a drawing. Well done. And now we can sing that song, "From Heaven You Came, Helpless Babe." And it reminds us that we're here to serve and to make the world a better place in God's name. Before we have our final prayer, Kevin's got some notices and things to tell us. So.
It's broken. Okay, great. We've got quite a few things to just quickly remind you about. So there's some people who are going to come up. Kerry's going to come first. Kathy, not too long behind, and Pauline come up about the Advent Supper. That'll be brilliant. Just you got 30 seconds to a minute, keeping in step with the star idea.
Okay, thank you. Anna, Joy and I would just like to say a great big thank you to everybody who supported the Light Party through your prayers, through your practical help in advance on the day. So many people were involved. I think it was something like 33 adults and 9 children and young people involved just in helping. For 2 hours on the 31st of October, we had the hall full of activity, crafts, games, lots of fairy lights, songs, short talk, food. The food was amazing. Thank you, catering team. Had an amazing time just offering the community an alternative to Halloween, and everybody went out with smiles on their faces, seemed to have had a lovely time. So thank you, church community, for supporting.
Like stars, eh?
Mm-hmm. So everyone who came to the Light Party had an invitation to our Stir Up Sunday event. All right, that is on the 20th of November. We turn this place into a giant kitchen where people come to mix their Christmas puddings. We provide all the ingredients, but we need a team of helpers. Thank you to those of you who've replied by email to say that you will be there to help. There's a list in the foyer for those of you not on email. If you'd like to come along and help, please sign up. Invite your friends and family, but come and help us get ready for Christmas. It would be great.
Super. So these cards on your chairs are not for you. They're actually for you to give to somebody else. And there's loads more in the foyer as well, so please do help yourselves. Not long to do it in. Pauline.
All right, the Advent Supper will take place on the 26th of November. I have to work out what month I mean. Sorry. At 7 o'clock, and you're all welcome to come along. Tickets are £5. You get a 3-course meal. And then we have a programme of songs and readings and various things to help us to prepare ourselves for Christmas and to realise that there's more to Christmas than just decorations and Christmas trees. So come along and enjoy some fellowship and a time just to focus on Christmas and the true meaning.
Super, thank you. So a few other things to make you aware of. So we've got something for us discipleship-wise. We've got mission going on as well, focusing outwards. As a church, today is the last call for deacons. So if you're nominating anyone and you haven't done it yet, then please make sure that is in writing to Heather today. On your seat is another leaflet about a partnership. As a church, we've discerned as members that we want to partner with Thrive Youth Ministries to commit to developing our youth work over the coming years. We recognise this is an area that we can improve in. It's explained on the leaflet, and you can chat to someone to find out more. But do take the leaflet, do pray about that, and if you want to ask any questions, ask someone on the leadership team. If you're not sure who they are, there's a load of mugshots out on the wall out there, and you can try and match them up with what they really look like today. But we need some names of people who aren't members. We'd like to get a balance, and then we'll have we'll think about that and put a team together. This evening, you're welcome to join us as we're praying for our brothers and sisters in the persecuted church. We will be in the lounge, but if loads more people turn up, we'll just open the doors again and we'll make space for people. So head for the lounge to start with 7:15. Do join us if you're able. And this Thursday is our next day of prayer and fasting. If you've no idea what I'm talking about, then there's information on our CHBC News taking you to the website. If you don't do online, there's paper copies of stuff in the lobby. Do grab something. If you really don't know what I'm talking about, then come and chat to me on the door and I'll explain. Finally, this will be coming out in the next week, but just advance notice that we've got a flyer covering then all the events, sort of special extra events coming up over the November Christmas period. They will be here for next week, assuming that I haven't made any spelling mistakes. And we'd love you to take them away and to be giving them to people, and to not just give, but talk, invite people, opportunity to show them a way of meeting and joining in as we seek to shine like stars in what we do as well.
Okay, one more thing for children. This is not for adults, just for children. If you want to make a rocket out of a piece of paper, while the adults are having their coffee, come up here. Well, I've got some paper, we'll make some rockets. Okay? Right, we're going to say a prayer and then our service will be over. Thank you, God, for the time that we spent this morning. Thank you for each other, but especially thank you for you and your love. And thank you for your challenge to us to be observant and to see you, the morning star, and to be like stars ourselves. So may your blessing, your love and your peace go with us into the rest of this day and this week. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with us all. Amen.